Hey friends, Ash here with GenSense. Today I'm coming at you guys with an Aventis clone review. Yeah, amazing, never done one of those before. But today is kind of a special Aventis clone review because this one is for Armoff Club de Nuit Intense Man Eau de Parfum. This is the limited edition version of Club de Nuit Intense Man, which is basically the most popular of all the Creed Aventis clones out there. I did a first impression on this limited edition when it first came in. I've been giving it wears off and on since that video, and now it's time for this review. So in this video, I'm going to let you guys know why I think that this limited edition version, the Eau de Parfum of Club de Nuit Intense Man, is better than the Eau de Toilette version of Club de Nuit Intense Man. And why, if you are in the market for a Creed Aventis clone, you should check this one out. This one should be right near the top of your list for clones. I'm gonna break down this limited edition Eau de Parfum, let you know how it's different than the Eau de Toilette. I'll talk about the performance with this fragrance as well, and go over the presentation with you like always. We've got a lot to talk about, guys, so let's just jump right into this and check out Club de Nuit Intense Man Eau de Parfum, the limited edition. First off, guys, let's check out this presentation. It does differ a good amount from the Eau de Toilette as far as how it's gonna come packaged to you. The most glaring difference in the presentation is going to be this. This is the outer box that's going to be over this box, which is what your bottle is actually going to come packaged inside of. So this comes wrapped up with this little ribbon that says Armoff, tied up in a nice little bow for you. So here is a look at this outer box. You can see right here this little cutout, which is where this shows through, the little fake crystal, fake diamond thing. You can see here it's the limited edition Armoff on the top of the box. The ribbon goes on the sides right there. And then on the back, just a little more information for you. On the bottom is where you're gonna find your batch code, which is right over here. It's gonna tell you when your bottle was made. So mine was made October 2019, made in France, and it has an expiration date, October 2024. And here's the box that your fragrance is going to come inside of. This one is a little bit of a step up from the box that the Eau de Toilette, the original, comes in. This one opens up like so, and your bottle sits down inside here. It's got kind of a felt foam feeling on the inside. So here's the front of the box for the limited edition, and then the back right there. And as I said, it opens up and the bottle sits down inside here. Now, this is a step up from the Eau de Toilette, like I said, as far as the presentation goes, but don't confuse this presentation with a high quality niche presentation, because that is not what this is. When you feel this in your hands, feels cheap. It doesn't feel like it was put together with high quality ingredients. It doesn't feel like a whole lot of money went into this, but it is a step up from the Eau de Toilette, the original's presentation. And now we'll take a quick look at the bottle. This is a fingerprint magnet. This is one of those reflective bottles where anytime you pick it up, it's gonna get all smudged up and it's not gonna look very nice. Essentially, when you first get this bottle and you look at it the first time, that's when it's gonna look its best. After that, it's gonna be a fingerprinted mess. So here it is, the limited edition Eau de Parfum. You can see what I'm talking about there, the fingerprints on the bottle. Overall, it's a nicer look than the black original bottle, in my opinion, other than the fingerprints. And of course, you could just wipe it down every time that you pick the bottle up, but really, who wants to do that? And one other difference between this one and the original is that the cap here is much sharper in terms of the angles. So this one is a square on the top of the cap, just like the original, but this one has kind of a rounded feel on the edges, just very slightly. This one does not at all. It is extremely sharp on the edges. Not really a big deal, but there is a difference there between the original in terms of packaging. The only other difference that I've noticed is the little medallion, the Armoff medallion. It hangs down lower on the limited edition bottle, and I'll show you what I'm talking about there. So here's the original on the left, the limited edition on the right, and you can see there the medallion hangs down lower than on this one here, the original. One other thing before I jump into how the fragrance actually smells, my original bottle of Club de Nuit Intense Man is the silver sprayer version. The atomizer here is silver, as you can see. the newer bottles of Club de Nuit Intense Man, this is going to be black, which is how it is here on the limited edition. Some people will tell you that newer bottles of Club de Nuit Intense Man, the original, the Eau de Toilette, with the black atomizer, do not perform as well as the original ones, which is what this one is. So I did want to let you guys know that. Now let me go ahead and waste a couple sprays for you so you can see how the atomizer works on the limited edition. Not bad. Now we can finally talk about the fragrance for Club de Nuit Intense Man Eau de Parfum and where it differs from the original Eau de Toilette. As I said at the beginning of this video, this is a Creed Aventus clone. So if for any reason you were unaware of that, this is a Creed Aventus clone. That is what this is trying to be. It's trying to take that DNA and basically redo or remake that fragrance only at a more affordable price. Now, where the original Club de Nuit Intense Man Eau de Toilette opens up with kind of a harsh opening, a lot of people would call it astringent or like a lemon cleaner kind of smell, like a lemon chemical cleaner. This one is much smoother. The limited edition, the Eau de Parfum, is not at all as harsh in the opening as the original is. In the Eau de Parfum, the limited edition, it comes across smoother, rounder, almost as if it's been aged a little bit to take off the harsh edges. Now, that's not what they did here. They didn't just take Club de Nuit Intense Man and age it. I'm just using that kind of as a metaphor. It also has this vanilla kind of sweetness very early on, the Eau de Parfum does. So it takes that fruity kind of sweetness from the original, removes the harshness, and then adds in a little bit of vanilla. There's also slightly less birch early on, which is where you're gonna get that smokiness in Club de Nuit Intense Man, just like in Creed Aventus. There's less of that in the Eau de Parfum. And that's actually one thing that stays true through the mid and the dry down. There's not as much woodiness in the Eau de Parfum. There's not as much smoke. So if that's the thing that you love the most about Club de Nuit Intense Man, do be aware of that with the Eau de Parfum. As the harshness in the original one is still kind of trying to settle down as it heads into the mid, the Eau de Parfum gets a good dose of black currant, which adds a little bit of tartness along with the fruity sweetness from the opening, which is going to be from the bergamot, the pineapple, and the apple in Club de Nuit Intense Eau de Parfum. The limited edition retains that smoothness from the opening, and it also has this almost sparkle or this pop, this effervescence to it, which is gonna come from ambroxan, at least that's how it comes across to me, along with a little bit of musk. Now, to be clear here, the Eau de Parfum does not come across like an entirely different fragrance than the Eau de Toilette. When you smell this, you're still like, yep, that's Club de Nuit Intense Man. But it smells like they took Club de Nuit Intense Man and fixed the things that you could say were wrong with it. So the changes here in the limited edition are slight. It's a slight tweak here, a slight tweak there. But for me, each one of those tweaks is positive. So on the whole, the limited edition, the Eau de Parfum, is a better fragrance. Again, the woodiness through the mid and into the dry down is more apparent here in the original, in the Eau de Toilette. In the Eau de Parfum, the limited edition, you do have a little bit of smokiness, you have a little bit of birch, a little bit of woodiness, but after about 4 hours on your skin in the far dry down, it's pretty much gone in the limited edition. You can still pick that woodiness up in the Eau de Toilette, but in the Eau de Parfum, in the far dry down, it's more vanilla and musk, a little bit of that ambroxan and some residual sweetness from the fruits from earlier on in the fragrance's life. The Eau de Parfum is a little bit sweeter overall, and for me is also a little bit more versatile overall. You can wear that one day or night, basically any season that you want. You can wear it to the office, you could wear it on a date, you could wear it casually if you wanted, you could wear it formally as well. So just like Creed Aventus, the fragrance that it's copying, the Eau de Parfum version of Club de Nuit Intense Man, very versatile. And to me, the Eau de Parfum is just better put together than the Eau de Toilette is. It has a clearer distinction between the notes. It doesn't come across as muddied, doesn't come across as muddled as the Eau de Toilette. Sometimes with the Eau de Toilette, everything kind of just fuses together almost. It's hard to pick out particular notes, but with the Eau de Parfum, you can pick those out clearer. Smells like it was made with higher quality ingredients. I also had my wife compare these side by side off my skin in the opening, the mid, the dry down, and asked her, which one do you think smells better? Which to you is more appealing? Which to you would you rather have me wear? And she picked the Eau de Parfum hands down every single time. And I've got to agree with her. Interestingly enough, the first time I sprayed this one on, she was in the room, but she wasn't watching what I was spraying. And she said, "Did you just spray on Pineapple Vintage Intense?" And no, it was actually Club de Nuit Intense Man Eau de Parfum. Now, to me, these don't smell the same, Pineapple Vintage Intense and Club de Nuit Intense Eau de Parfum. But to her, standing across the room, not watching what I was spraying, that's the first thing she thought of. And with this one, the original, she did not make that same comparison to Pineapple Vintage Intense. Now, again, to me, Pineapple Vintage Intense and Club de Nuit Intense Man Eau de Parfum are very different. But where this one does have that higher quality kind of fruity sweetness to it in the opening, through the mid, and even into the dry down, that's where my wife drew that comparison to Pineapple Vintage Intense, which, as a lot of you know, is one of her favorite fragrances of all time. Now let's talk about performance. The performance on this one is actually right on par with the Eau de Toilette. And again, this is one of the older style bottles. This one, the Eau de Parfum, lasts over 8 hours off my skin without an issue whatsoever, and it projects very well for the first few hours. Because the performance of the Eau de Parfum is so good, in really high heat, I would not want to wear more than a couple sprays of Club de Nuit Intense Man Limited Edition. You don't want it to choke people out or, you know, offend them because it's just projecting out too hard. So in high heat, I probably would dial that one back a little bit. Now, as of this video, the cheapest that I could find this fragrance, the limited edition, was about $56 US. Now that is a lot more than Club de Nuit Intense Man Eau de Toilette, the original, because I can find this one, I believe, in the $25 to $26 range. So that means the limited edition is a little bit over twice the cost of the original. Now, do I think that the limited edition is over twice the quality of the original? No, I really don't. But if I put them side by side, head to head, would I rather have the Eau de Parfum or the Eau de Toilette? The Eau de Parfum all day, every day. So ultimately, with the limited edition, whether it's going to work for you is going to come down to a couple of different things. Are you just looking for the cheapest Aventus alternative possible that's going to get you a similar DNA, that's going to get you good performance, that can pull compliments, things like that? If that's what you're after, then the Eau de Toilette probably is still going to be the best way to go, just because it is so much cheaper. If you're looking for something that's going to be a higher quality alternative to Creed Aventus, still much cheaper than Creed Aventus, but with, again, higher quality of ingredients and, in my opinion, higher quality fragrance overall with more versatility, then that's when you should check this one out, the Eau de Parfum. Now, this one is a limited edition. It says right there on the bottle, but do I know realistically if it is limited or if that's just marketing? I don't know. I don't have any contacts with Armoff or anything like that, so I can't tell you whether this is just a marketing gimmick where they're saying limited edition, but then it's actually going to be out forever, or if this is a limited edition and then a year or two from now, it's going to be really difficult to find. I can't tell you that because I don't know. As far as the fragrance goes, though, this is a very nice Creed Aventus clone, one of the best on the market. The presentation is slightly better than the original, but to be honest, I don't really care about this presentation. I don't think it's that nice. Like I said, when you hold it in your hands, it does have a cheap kind of flimsy feeling to it, like at any moment, if you really, you know, open this and closed it a few times, that the edges would start flaking up and this box would fall apart. But the fragrance itself is what matters, and this one is a darn good Creed Aventus clone. And as far as Armoff goes, this one is one of their better fragrances that I've ever smelled. So for those reasons, I think that right now, if you don't have any Aventus clones and you're thinking about getting one, and for whatever reason you don't want to save up or pony up the cost for a real Creed Aventus, this one should be right at the top of your list of fragrances to check out. It does most of the things that the original does well, just as well, if not better. And some of the things that the original didn't do so well, this one corrects. Again, the changes are slight between the two, but the changes are all positive, in my opinion. And that, guys, is gonna wrap up my thoughts on Club de Nuit Intense Man Eau de Parfum, the limited edition version of Club de Nuit Intense Man by Armoff. I should say one last thing do not get ripped off on this fragrance. If you go to eBay, there are some people asking, as of this video, like $120 for this bottle. Do not pay $120 for an Aventus clone from Armoff. Even though this is a limited edition Eau de Parfum, don't do it, you're getting screwed. I paid right in that $56 range for this one. I don't think you should go any higher than that. Anything over $60, I think you're paying too much, just to be clear. Anyway, if you've smelled this one, let me know in the comments below what you think about it. As always, thanks so much for all your support, and I'll see you guys again tomorrow with another fragrance video. See you guys. Thank you.